Já jsem původně z Prahy, já jsem v Ostravě nikdy nebyl. Víte, jakou má Ostrava reputaci mezi obyvateli Československa a České republiky. Charakterizoval bych to tím, jak mě jednou taxikář, když mě ves na letiště, říkal, moje nejhorší noční můra je, že bych skončil v Ostravě. Já jsem mu říkal, to tam teď zrovna jedu. Jsem začal pracovat s Janáčkou filharmonií na velkých projektech symfonického orchestru. Z nějakého důvodu jsem si nejen Ostravu oblíbil, ale také jsem byl přesvědčen, že takový projekt by tady byl velice vhodný, že by se tady dal dělat a že by to bylo dobře ho dělat. Takže jsem přišel s tímto nápadem a the rest is history, jak se říká.
Každé dva roky se do Ostravy sjíždějí hudebníci z celého světa. Skladatelé, dirigenti, interpreti, improvizátoři, teoretici, kritikové a samozřejmě studenti. A to, co se zde děje, to bych přirovnal k jakési obrovské tavbě, protože každý sem přináší svoje myšlenky a zde na sebe působí a vzniká zde něco nového.
Vlastně, když Petr Kotík před těmi 10 dneska už lety přišel s tím projektem Ostravských dnů, tak tomu v podstatě nikdo nevěřil, že to může fungovat. Včetně mě teda. A dneska po těch 10 letech Ostravských dnů to vlastně každý bere trošku jako samozřejmost. Když bychom chtěli pojmenovat prostě to, co je specifický u Ostravských dnů, tak je to kombinace prostředí, hudby, jo, je to událost na místě, kde by to, co si budeme vykládat, vlastně jako nikdo nečekal.
It's a very rich experience, particularly for the students when they come, as well as for people like me coming to listen, I find it, I don't listen that much to instrumental music, and so when I come here, it's like a real immersion of a week and a half. I mean, I'm much more likely to hear things at festivals where I go, where it's much more electronic, or people with laptops, or some combination of instruments then.
Snažíme proniknout do toho, co se dnes dělá v hudbě a ze všech úhlů. Nejenom z úhlu lidí, kteří pracují jakožto skladatelé, ale myslím profesionálním slova smyslu, kteří mají objednávky a komponují a jezdí a dirigují a tak dále, ale také z úhlu studentů, kteří sem přijíždí.
It's a composition workshop. Which is basically, I think it's the core of the festival, is this young students coming from all over Europe or even the world and being in very close contact to advanced composers, and they really work hard, they present their compositions, the composers present their things, and it's a very special and very friendly and very intense atmosphere of permanent communication about everything.
V roce 2003 nebo 2001 viděl plakát na Ostravské dny, vyset někde na Janáčkově konzervatoři. A teď tam byly všechny ty velký jména, jako Christian Wolff, Phil Nibilk a podobně. A teď jsem viděl ten plakát a říkal jsem si, wow, tady ty lidi tady budou jako v Ostravě teď. 20 kilometrů od místa, kde žiju, nebo v místě, kde studuju zrovna. Takže jsem si řekl, tam musím být, to bylo jednoduché.
I was completely unprepared for this barrage of music that would ensue for 3 weeks. And when I say music, I mean lectures, presentations, events, sort of interesting, strange little activities that happen throughout Ostrava. Of course, concerts that just go on and on and on.
So institute means we get lectures and discussions, and we get to meet composers, which are, in some cases, our idols. And then there's a week of festival, which is packed with all this wonderful music that we don't get to hear that often.
This is music that you don't get a chance to hear very often. And you mentioned two American composers, Cage and Feldman. And in fact, you hear them more often in Ostrava than you do in New York.
I live in New York City, and hearing these kind of pieces played within such a short span of time is fairly unimaginable, I think.
The festival gives a unique opportunity to the young composers to meet not only composers, but conductors, but computer specialists, whatever, and then also to get good opportunity to hear your own music played by the Ostravska Banda, who is a highly professional ensemble, or by the Janáček Philharmonic Orchestra.
And they're taken seriously. The students that get performances here learn more in this week of concerts than in a full academic year somewhere at some music school or university or whatever. Because this is reality. This is what, you know, music making is really about.
Especial aqui nesse festival é a possibilidade de ter um contato informal. É, todos estão no mesmo ambiente, mais ou menos circulando durante 3 semanas. Então, você pode ter esse contato imediato com os artistas, além dos encontros formais, como leituras e aulas individuais. Lendo sobre ele, sobre a música, a gente não espera, às vezes, o que é o ser humano dele. E é muito interessante, porque depois a gente reconfigura a nossa escuta em relação ao trabalho artístico da pessoa.
Yeah, all of a sudden they invite lecturers, composers, who are very interesting people. For me, talking to Bernhard Lang or Richard Ayres is actually always a turning point in for me as an artist.
I think I've learned a lot more than I've helped other people with. I think I have to go back and see what I'm doing with my own music. Amazing. I think I would prefer to come here for 3 weeks than study for 3 years. I think it's that kind of quality, you know, that you hear really people at the top of the game, and they come here and talk and share and discuss things. I think it's amazing.
Thank you. Performing here for in a region that has been largely isolated from the Western avant-garde tradition, and then seeing people's reaction and seeing people enjoying it and opening their minds to it has been very enjoyable.
Jsem tady jako interpret a také jako vlastně posluchač, jako divák. Takže sleduji Ostravské dny nové hudby jako něco naprosto výjimečného vlastně v kontextu kulturním, vlastně nejenom národním, ale jako i mezinárodním si myslím. Díky Petru Kotíkovi a všem, kteří vlastně tohleto provozují. A opravdu pro mě to je vždycky nejen záležitost tedy si tady zahrát, ale opravdu načerpat nové impulzy.
So what I like about this festival is that you go to see Elliot Sharp playing and it's followed by Boulez. I just find that very, very interesting because typically Elliot Sharp would be someone in the downtown scene in New York. And Boulez would be played uptown. This festival seems to get rid of that, these ideas that there's something like uptown or downtown. It's just about the quality of music.
Zde byli výteční hráči, výteční solisté, Těší nás to, že oni sem nejezdí kvůli tomu, že bychom jim mohli poskytovat ohromné honoráře. Oni sem jezdí kvůli tomu, protože se cítí velmi dobře být zasazeni do programu, jaký děláme.
Students who usually get here are quite advanced normally because they have a huge range of people to pick from and they tend to pick very high-level people, I think, so that you get very few students who are coming in as not very experienced.
Some of them will be famous composers.
The ticking of eternity, I saw and heard and knew at last the how and why of all things past and present and forever.
One of the nice things about being a student is that you don't have to deal with extreme responses to your work, either positive or negative. I think students generally should not be reviewed. Be in an atmosphere where you're not waiting to see what the newspaper is going to say the next day. That's one of the things that's great about Ostrava, is that it's remote from a lot of other places, and we're here to share music with one another, not to evaluate and try to make some big impression on the world, although more people are coming from far away.
This was a fantastic experience. I think the quality of the people here, they're intellectual energies and focus was made for a very charged atmosphere. I enjoyed very much both giving the talks, working with the various musicians, meeting with the individual students, and of course hearing my music played by great players.
The festival is just extraordinary. I mean, 9 solid days of music, constant music, and being surrounded by composers and performers and people that operate on such a high intellectual aesthetic level. It's just extraordinary. It feels fantastic.
Really appreciate it about this festival that it's non-dogmatic. There's a lot of things happening here which could not have happened in Vienna, because or in other cities where a certain dogmatic state of the art is being decreed. And this is much more open, and I appreciate it.
Especially from countries that I didn't have the chance to meet before, and that was really good.
To bring your own material and see how other people think about it, usually you don't get an opportunity to talk to people from many different countries around the world, so it's nice to see what they think about your work, and it's even more nice to see what they're doing themselves.
I could have a little bit more distance to my own music when I'm as observing and I was listening to the other composers' music, and I think it will also change my point of view to my composition.
Times now already, and my main occupation when I come here is to play as a double bassist in the chamber orchestra, Ostravska Banda. And over the years, it has developed to a point where we also try to give certain people opportunity to have music of have solo performance of various sorts. Thursday was quite an important day for me because I performed pretty much all of the spectrum of music that I'm interested in.
The main idea behind of the program yesterday was that all the composers composed for us. Aurel Holo and Zoltán Váci, they are member of the group, and also John Cage. We had a very, very close connection with him. And in 1991, he composed a piece, 72 minutes long piece for us.
Christian Wolff is a very intriguing composer from his position in the sort of circle around Cage from New York, and his music is always very interesting in a rather different direction. You never quite know how it develops. It's just a very enlivening experience having him here. He has the music that's done here. He's usually presenting a new piece every time he visits, and it's always something new and something we've never expected. I'm always very fascinated by what comes out of that.
To get three conductors together in a, yes, let's call it democratic way, and that's a bit challenging, of course.
I don't know if I get new ideas. I've been around a long time, but what I get is energy in the company of these younger people who are just, you know, starting off and are full of new thoughts and looking for new things. I think that's the main effect, yeah.
Ostrovska Banda, they're not an orchestra, they're a banda. They're a band. I like bands more than orchestras. I think the Duke Ellington Orchestra must have been something like that. The idea that you get people together, even from all over the world, to play together and have this tight understanding of each other is something quite rare. And I've seen them developing. And I mean, a difference between my previous participation is that I saw the banda play good last time. And on certain occasions this time, I saw them approaching world class.
síla Ostravských dnů a Petra Kotíka je v tom, že věci, které jsou velmi nesamozřejmé, se prezentují velmi samozřejmým způsobem. Jako by to bylo něco úplně normálního. A když tohle uděláte, když konfrontujete lidi s hudbou, která je svým způsobem velmi specifická, velmi nestandardní, nezvyklá, když jim to předložíte, jakože se jedná o úplně normální věc, a ona to je prostě normální věc, protože to dělají normální lidi, to vnímání té hudby a přijetí té hudby je najednou úplně jiný, je snadný, je vlastně stejným způsobem přirozený a jde hladce. V Ostravě se v podstatě děje malej zázrak, ale nikdo to netvrdí, že to je zázrak. Jo, je to normální věc. Z těch lidí, kdo mají kulturní zájmy, sledují současné výtvarné umění, divadlo, experimentální, nezávislou kinematografii, tak pokud v Ostravě ještě nebyli a neznají tu akci, tak je to jejich chyba.
Co děláme my a také reagujeme na to, co vidíme, co dělají ostatní, a tak to je tak asi ostravský dny.